In this section of the course, we'll learn how to perform a retrospective review of your analytical system and how frequently this review should occur. We'll learn how to incorporate the use of total allowable error and total error plots into the review. Let's move on to the next question. Is the total allowable error specification appropriate for the test? To answer this question, we need to consider the following. Should the quality goal be narrowed? Should the quality goal be widened? If the following conditions occur together, then a test's performance is much better than the set quality specification, and narrowing of the quality goal may be considered. No bias. No imprecision. The total error plot has a lot of white space. In other words, the space in which no values lie. When a laboratory is unable to meet its quality specification for TEA, widening the quality specification is a poor option. However, it may be an interim strategy if, during the initial setup, the test performance was overestimated, or if the original selection of the quality specification was performed on faulty data. If a quality specification for a test has been in use for some time, and the quality specification is suddenly exceeded, then the appropriate response would be to determine the root cause and take corrective action. Reassigning of the quality specification should not be done. Let's address the last question. What does analysis of the total error plots indicate? Let's look at several examples of what can be ascertained from analyzing a total error plot. What does it mean when the process control rejections are few and well within the total allowable error limits? It means the QC protocol is working effectively and is appropriate. It also indicates less stringent rules could be used. For example, a 1-4S rather than a 1-3S or a multi-rule approach may be eliminated. What does it mean when there is a lot of white space? In other words, the space in which no value lies. This implies the laboratory can move to a higher level of performance, thereby tightening the range of the plot. This example shows the same data on a plot with a TEA calculated at a higher performance level, BV optimum, rather than BV desirable. There's considerably less white space, and the values are still well within the limits of the plot. What does it mean when there are many unwarranted process control rejections on the plot? This could indicate that the process control scheme is not appropriate and should be revised, or that the mean and SD are not accurately calculated and applied. What does it mean when a TE plot shows relative bias, where most of the points are higher or lower than the group mean? The importance of this bias is dependent upon the level of quality chosen by the laboratory in construction of the total error plot. Although action to improve the bias should always be taken, the degree of the response is in direct proportion to the used quality specification. In the case of minimum imprecision and minimum bias, the lowest level of acceptable performance, this bias must be acted on immediately. Any further deterioration could result in reporting of patient test results containing too much error. Another important item to remember about relative bias is its effect on proficiency testing results. Laboratories are compared to a peer group in proficiency testing schemes, and unrecognized bias or uncorrected bias can lead to proficiency testing failures. What does it mean when the TE plot shows a lot of dispersion due to a large standard deviation? The importance of this dispersion pattern is once again related to the level of performance chosen by the laboratory in the construction of the total error plot. In the case of minimum imprecision and minimum bias, the lowest level of acceptable performance, this imprecision pattern must be acted on immediately. Remember, total allowable error is a budget, and if the budget is used entirely by imprecision, then relative bias must be 0%, or the laboratory may produce patient test results that are not acceptable. What does it mean when the TE plot shows a lot of dispersion and relative bias? Again, this dispersion pattern is related to the level of performance chosen by the laboratory in the construction of the total error plot. If the quality chosen was optimum or desirable for the imprecision and the bias, then neither the imprecision or bias represent an immediate problem and can be dealt with in an appropriate time scale. On the other hand, if minimum imprecision and minimum bias were used to construct the plot, then the imprecision and bias should be dealt with promptly, or the laboratory risks reporting unreliable patient test results. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.